Hey there guys, I'm the Royal Gorilla and welcome to my 10,000 subscriber milestone video. Today we are going to be playing The Crew, and this is my beautiful challenger, which we are going to be using for this video today, and we are going to be going on a bit of an American road trip. So just over where we are now, let me get the map up. That's not the map, that's the map. We are down in the Florida Keys at the very, I guess it's the furthest point on the right you can really go. Not necessarily over here, but that doesn't matter. It's like the furthest away we can go from our destination, which will be up in this very top left corner, which is apparently Seattle. So that's where we're going to be heading, and we are going to set a waypoint there. Maybe we shouldn't put it right there. Let's maybe put it on the corner. No, we'll do it there. So that is the route we're going to be taking, which is, it's not a bad route, but I seem to have done it before. I might change that up a little bit. Maybe if we go up to the top and across that way. Maybe. I don't, because I've done this route before. I don't really want to have to do it again. So I'm thinking maybe through Vegas. So let's set a waypoint for Vegas. And then from Vegas, we will head to, there we go. That's a better waypoint. I have done that one before, but I particularly like that route because it's got quite a lot of the sites on it that I've been to in actual life. So, let us get going. I am going the wrong way already. I've killed a person. This could take quite a while, and I've killed more people. I don't think you can actually hit someone in this. Let's try. No, apparently they just jump out of the way. I really find it annoying when they do that. They have a police system in this game, but you still can't hit anybody. Now, I bet if you could, they couldn't put it as, like, what is the age rating of this game? It's a 12. Yeah, if you could hit people, I doubt they would be able to keep it as a 12. I think this is maybe going to take, I don't know, half an hour minimum. I've done this route before, not up to Seattle. It would be the first time I've been there. And I've been to LA. That takes, I don't know, to be honest. This could be, like, up to an hour long. So get settled down for the long haul. I do have some things to do while we are driving. I have the questions that I got from the I call it the subscriber appreciation video, because that's pretty much what it was. I was just saying thank you to everyone that subscribed, all 10,000 of you. You are all amazing, and I am very grateful. And I have a fair few questions. I should be able to keep us going most of the time with them. I won't just kind of like rattle them off quickly. I'll kind of pace them. So I think pretty much everyone's questions are on there. I don't remember not using a question, but if anyone does post a question once I've recorded this video, obviously it won't be in this video. So if you kind of missed the cutoff date, then I'm sorry, but I might answer your question another time in some other video. But I've got a good selection, and yeah, they're pretty interesting questions. Right, how far do we have to go in miles? We're going, 69 miles. That's how far we have to go. That's it's a fair old slog, I'll give you that. But it shouldn't be too hard. Okay. I don't think we're out of the Florida area. Oh, no, we're still in the Keys. Oh, okay, I was not looking, I was looking at the map. That'll probably happen quite a lot. What is happening? Why is it doing that? Let's, there's a car. Let's just not do that. Let's see if it still does that. What is it doing that for? Every time I look behind, it flashes. Weird. See if it does it in third person. No, it's fine in that view. Oh, that's a strange one. And we have also got some just random people around the world. If you haven't played The Crew before, it's actually kind of a cool game. I don't really do it for the racing aspect. I did it more, well, I bought the game purely for the fact that it was just America and you could drive across it. I just thought that was a really cool, like, idea, really, that you could just have this, massive world. I've always loved games with massive worlds. That's the reason I bought Fuel, just because how big the world was. That's the reason I first played Just Cause, but then Just Cause was an awesome game, which we'll actually get onto later with some of the questions. I just like really big open worlds, even if they haven't got much in it like this. This is, I know this is full of races and stuff like that, but beyond that, it's a pretty sparse world, to be honest. It doesn't even look that good, but I just kind of like to explore. I like to go to all the places that are famous, I guess. Like, I think we're obviously going to go through Vegas, so we'll see a few of the Vegas stuff. I don't know if Hoover Dam's on this route. It'll be nice if it is. I've been there a few times. Grand Canyon, perhaps. It would just be really cool to see all these places in the game. I've seen them once already, but that was a while ago. So, oh god. Really nice lighting on them sparks. Let's do that again. I'm gonna lit up the entire, look. Oh, that's kind of cool. Oh, there's a, is that a policeman? That's a taxi. Oh, like it weren't a policeman. Flash, flash, flash. I wonder why it's doing that. I don't remember it doing that before. There was a patch this morning. Maybe they broke it. Well, it wasn't necessarily this morning. It could have been like a month ago because I haven't played it in so long. Well, okay. That was going well. I could have probably done this trip a lot faster if I had have got my Viper. Both my cars are Dodges. I just realised that. A Dodge Viper and a Dodge Challenger. Now, I'm really early in the game, so I don't really have very many decent cars. So this is pretty much the first car you can start with. There's a few to select from, but... ow. This is one of the first. Okay, I think... what are we on now? 64 miles to go. I think it's high time that we answered our first question. And if I crash while I'm doing this... oh, God. I'm sorry. Okay. Okay, our first question. I'll get through these cars so I can actually read it. Right. It's from... okay. I always find this name really hard. I don't know if it's Lewis or Luis or Louise. So it's not Louise, is it? But I'm going to say Lewis Pemberton. This is from Lewis Pemberton on YouTube. And he asks, why is your name The Royal Gorilla? And he also states that it is a cool name. Why is my name The Royal Gorilla? It's actually kind of a really boring story as to why my name is actually The Royal Gorilla. So, if you didn't know, the Royal Gorilla is not the first channel I had. It's probably like the 8th, and every single one of them I was trying something different, I guess, just trying to find out what holds. And we came from stuff like, obviously, I think there was one that was just my name, and then we had one called BioHXL, which was kind of me and my friend doing Minecraft videos, and that really didn't go anywhere. Then I had an old gamer tag called Zombie Vision, which was like zombie videos and like Call of Duty, that kind of thing. That didn't really take off either. And then one day I was like, okay, I just need to completely refresh what I'm doing, come up with a whole new identity for this, and just set about doing some videos which hopefully people will like and that I enjoy. So I wanted to find a name which combines kind of something I love and something that I can identify with, if you know what I mean. So, obviously, I'm from England, a British, and I wanted something in my name that would kind of highlight that. So, I was like, what's undisputably British? I don't know, the royal family. There you go. That was it. This is pretty much what I did. I sat down and I was like, let's think of a name that will work. There was no, like, I don't know, there's no really interesting backstory behind it. It was just me sitting down one day and being like, let's think of something cool. The royal family's cool. Well, the royal family's not cool. No one really cares. Well, some people do. Royalists care, but the majority don't. So I was like, okay, royal gorilla. Gorilla, favorite animal. They're just cool. That's pretty much it. My favorite animal and something that was British. It's not a very interesting story, but it's stuck. And I thought it was kind of cool. So that is where the name the royal gorilla came from. To any of you that were wondering, not a very interesting story, but you asked it. I wish there was a more interesting story. It would be far more interesting to tell. But no, I sat down and was... just came up with it, really. See, me, all the greatest stories to tell. Right, how far are we? 57. This is kind of going faster than I expected, actually. Right, I'm going to... oh, God. There's not going to be any editing in this video. Hopefully not, unless something goes wrong or I say something that I shouldn't. There shouldn't be any editing at all, really. It'll be quite a nice video to make. I'll literally just put the audio... Why am I talking you through my editing process? Okay, I think we need another question already. Oh, God, we're crashing. Right, another question. Who is my second question from? My second question is from a weird face, but it's Caden Robinson. Robinson. Caden Robinson. I've never heard of Robinson. Maybe it's a typo or something. I don't know. Caden's actually quite an active subscriber. I've seen him around the place quite a bit, actually. So Hello, Caden. I hope you say the Caden like that. Maybe I'm completely saying that wrong. Sorry if I am. Right, I need to slow down for a minute so I can actually read this. Oh, God. Okay, right. Let's pull over because I'm no good at reading and this is why you should never text and drive people. Okay. So, the question from Caden is, and it's from Twitter, actually. I didn't notice that. If you had one chance to play with any other people on YouTube, who would it be and why? And he also says, PS, congrats on the 10K. Thank you very much. Who would I play with on YouTube and why? I had a bit of a think about this. And I think there's really two people. Like, one's a group and the other one's just a person. And it probably won't be much of a surprise, one of them. But I don't know if... Okay, one of them is, of course, Nerdcubed. He is pretty much the YouTuber that I'll never miss one of his videos. He is pretty much, I would say, oh, he's what got me into YouTube, but that's a lie. He is what made me look at it and be like, ah, YouTube videos can have really high quality content and they can be funny and they don't have to just be shoutcasts, which is something I absolutely hate. Like, Markiplier is to a lesser extent a shoutcaster, but there are so many of them out there. I kind of like Markiplier a bit. Why am I talking about Markiplier? Yeah, I really don't like shoutcasters. I don't find them interesting. I think it just kind of comes with age. I understand that younger audiences might find them funny, but I myself are looking for a kind of more, not sophisticated, but more, I can't say intelligent either, because if you've if you've watched any of Nerdcubed's videos, those are not intelligent videos. It's just a difference between humour that I like and humour that's shouting at a game, really. And sure, that can be funny sometimes, but the majority of the time, I'd much rather a really bad pun from Nerdcube than, I don't know, it's Jacksepticeye just shouting at whatever game he's playing at the minute. And that's not to badmouth him, it's just a different take on, just different opinion on different aspects of how YouTube works, really. I'm just not really into shoutcasters, and I know many people are, and I... Is there a train? Okay, we've crashed. Don't miss the train, don't miss the train! Oh, no, I missed the train. Right, I wonder if we can catch it. I know this is a complete distraction, but... Oh, God! How could I resist doing this? Oh, God! Ow, ow, ow! There's a pole there. That train is the blurriest train I've ever seen. I'm riding next to it and it's still got motion blur on it. Ow, ow, ow. Okay, I'm going the complete wrong direction. Can I overtake the train? That'd be interesting. Come on, come on. We could get him around the corner, but it's not as fast as he looked. Oh, it's giving us a different route. We'll just take that in a second, I guess. Oh, yes. There you go. That is a view you don't want. Oh, God. I should... Ow. What is handbrake? Is it A? No, A's boost. I didn't really realise I had a boost. Sorry, where was I? Yeah, Nerdcubed is definitely one of the people I would love to play something with. GTA with him would be probably funny as shit, basically. That'd be great to have anything with him, really. Just something that... I don't know, just anything with Nerdcubed. I'm not going to go into specifics. And I might have just thought of another one, actually. The Uxcast guys, that would be... it would be good to play with them, purely because they are pretty much the first channel I ever watched on YouTube. They are probably who made me get into YouTube, and just to be able to play with someone that you've seen and respected for so long, it would be really incredible. And they are just really funny guys. Like the GTA videos they're doing at the minute, really funny. Especially, I absolutely love the work they're doing with the GTA editor. I love the GTA editor too. It's so cool. I just love making machinimas. I just think it's really cool. So the Uxcast are another one. That would be really fun to just have a play with them. And probably this is the one that most people wouldn't really expect, but Rooster Teeth. Achievement Hunter, like, more so than Rooster Teeth. But yeah, I absolutely love Rooster Teeth. They're pretty much my dream of what I want to get out of YouTube, basically. I don't want to... Oh, it's really strange to talk about, but I could almost imagine Royal Gorilla, like, in my wildest dreams, evolving into something Rooster Teeth-esque, where we do so many different things, make movies and shorts, and I just love all that kind of thing, because we'll get onto this a bit later, but like my hobbies outside of YouTube are all basically around that kind of area, and to play with the Achievement Hunt a lot would be, oh, it'd be so much fun, because I think they're really funny guys, and pretty much any game they do, they... Oh god, have I got the police after me? Oh no, that guy does. Yeah, the Achievement Hunter guys there, I just love their content. I think it's really funny. That flashing is really annoying me. So, yeah, there you go. They are three YouTubers I'd love to play a game with. Is that what the question was? Play a game. You had one chance to play with any other. Yeah, those three. Yeah, so Achievement Hunter, YorksCast, and Dan Nerd Cubed. Have I seen this before? I don't know, let's try it. Oh, that is really annoying me that flashes. Welcome to Nashville. Who lives in Nashville? Isn't it that jackass person? Sorry, I'm not very in touch with locations. I'm really bad at geography. Never been good at geography. Okay, that's enough of that. Right, let's carry on our road trip. And I have lost now, haven't there? It's back, the line's back. How far have we got? 50 miles. That went a bit slow. So how many have we done? We've done 19 and we've got 50 left. We're not even halfway. Oh, joyous. We'll be at halfway when we have 35 left, for those of you that couldn't work that out. Well, just about. I rounded it up. But it probably was 70 by the time we set out. So, right. What's next? I have plenty of questions, so I'm just going to keep answering them. Okay, who asked me this? Randomness Overload on Twitter asked me, are you married? And if not, are you dating anyone? And I answered that one. Oh, I read that one out. Oh, God. Without stopping. So, which you should be proud of. You should be proud of that, people. And Randomness Overload, the answer to the question is, yes, I am with someone. No, I am not married. You might be kind of new to the channel, I guess. Because if you haven't seen any of my older videos, I've got quite a few titled My Girlfriend Plays, which is Lauren playing all sorts of things. She played quite a lot of horror games, which is kind of a bit shoutcasty, I guess. But there's nothing wrong with shoutcasty, it depends on the audience, and I know like younger audiences in particular like that kind of thing, so it made sense. I'm just not that kind of personal myself. Like, she'll scream at a game because she gets scared, whereas I don't know, I've never been that sort. So it kind of gives a bit more diversity to the channel. Anyway, yeah, Lauren is... She actually has her own YouTube channel now, which I'll put a link in the description for you, and it's Heart Start Repeat. I helped her make it, and she does kind of frequent vlogs and challenges and stuff, and she just does it for the fun more than anything. She doesn't really do it for the views. It was more the fact that when I was at uni, she needed a hobby to keep her interested since I was away for 90% of the time. So she started a YouTube channel, and I think it's quite good. I'm in quite a lot of the videos if you want to go over there and see that. If you like what you see, make sure you subscribe, because I quite like it. She's getting better, definitely. Like, when she started, she didn't even understand what editing was, and now she pretty much edits all her videos on her own and films them herself, and she's doing pretty well, and I'm pretty proud of her. So yes, in answer to your question, Randomness Overload. Overload? Overload. Even though you spell overload strangely. Randomness Overload, I am not married, and I do have a girlfriend. Her name is Lauren. She's been on the channel. Actually, we recently did that that girl versus guy. That was the most recent video with her in it. So, if you saw that, then she is my girlfriend. Yay. She's also done a couple of Easter eggs with me, I think. I kind of, from time to time, get her to do some voiceovers for me, just because it kind of gives a little more variety, and I guess it's quite a good tactic to draw more people in, because lots of people like a nice female voice. I know I do. Yeah, so that's pretty much it, me and Lauren. And we're probably like, how long we've been together now? 4 years, maybe? It's not, I don't know. I honestly don't know. Our anniversary is on July the 5th, so I think it's 4 years in July. That's a long time. Oh god. Oh god. Ah! What? Okay, that's not handbrake. What is handbrake? Right, let's try and work this out. X is handbrake. Okay. X is handbrake. Right, let's head back in. Cool. Right. Where are we now? 42 miles. That 8 miles went really quickly. Right, I need to get through more of these questions because I have far more than I've read out. Colossics? Colossics? I think that's how you say it. Colossics AU. Is that Australia? I don't know, maybe. Asks, what are your hobbies outside of YouTube? And I said we'd come back to this topic. My hobbies outside of YouTube are pretty much my hobbies on YouTube. So I play games. When I'm not recording a video, I just play games for fun, really. And I think that's really important when you do YouTube. When I said do. I'm so immature. When you do YouTube, being able to still play games for fun is really important. It just kind of stops it becoming a chore, really. And at the minute, I'm playing The Witcher 3, and I've sunk too many hours into that game. I'm also playing the Minecraft Xbox One edition, trying to get some last achievements on it, which is kind of cool. I've got a whole new world I'm building. Ow. Ow. Come on, get out of there. There we go. Nice. So I game. Of course, I am at YouTube at the minute. At YouTube? At university at the minute. I'm not right now. I'm on my summer break. So I have awful lot of work to do there. So hobbies kind of can't stretch too far beyond like gaming. But I like making movies. That's something I really enjoy, making shorts and that kind of thing. I never really release them. I'll film something and then be like, that's awful. I'm not going to release that. But it's a learning experience, really. I'm just getting better and learning how to do it. And one day, maybe I will release an Oscar-worthy performance. I don't know. So that is pretty much me. I game and... Oh, my voice went really high-pitched then. That's pretty much me. I game and make movies. Any other hobbies, really? No. Not really. I don't know if cycling, not bicycling. That's stupid. Cycling is that a hobby? I just do that more for exercise. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Pretty much what you see is what you get. I do games on YouTube, I do games in my spare time. Sad life. Not a sad life. I don't really care. I watch lots of YouTube videos. That's probably a hobby. Too many YouTube videos, really. Oh god, watch that car. So, that's another question. 38 miles left. Oh, we're nearly halfway. And I'm not halfway through my questions yet. Right, I'm going to have to start rattling these out a bit quicker. Hellbringer457 asks, what is your favourite franchise? My favourite franchise? That's a really hard question. My favourite franchise? So difficult. My favourite game isn't my favourite franchise because I haven't played the entire franchise, if you know what I mean. Like, if I wanted to answer the question, what's my favourite franchise, I'd want it to be something that I've played multiple games of and pretty much enjoyed them all. In which case it would probably have to be Grand Theft Auto. For the one of the pure facts that... Ow. It's probably one of the first games I played. It's also one of the games I still play. One of the games I've played every iteration of and pretty much enjoyed every version of. Like, I can't think of one GTA game that I didn't enjoy, and some of them are really vastly different, and some of them aren't. Like, games like Vice City, Liberty City, Liberty City Stories, I played them on PSP, and I also played them on PS2 in Grand Theft Auto 3, I believe, and they were great games, and Grand Theft Auto has just been a series that's always been strong. There's never been one where you're like, oh, that was an awful game. I guess that kind of extends to most Rockstar games in general. There's a couple of exceptions. I did play Mad Max, and it was alright. It wasn't a bad game. It was fun while it lasted, but I'm more talking about Red Dead Redemption, because that is a fantastic game. And if that was a franchise, I know it's got Red Dead Revolver before it, but never played that, so I can't really say I've played the franchise. But, oh, there's a ramp back there. I want to take that ramp. I also heard gunshots. Was that just me? Yeah, so I think Grand Theft Auto's got to be my... Wait, I can hear that still. You can hear that. It's not. What is it? Is that roadworks? Oh yeah, there's some. I've never noticed that people did this before. Huh. It's a shame I couldn't get out of the car, really. Right, there's our ramp. Let's back up, get some speed, and let's kill a workman. Come on. Oh, God, this car, I don't think this car's fast enough. Maybe I should have brought the Dodge Viper, but then, I don't know, maybe the video would be too short. We're already on 27 minutes, and we're just under halfway, so it should actually be an hour-long video, which is cool. Did I? That was a disappointing jump. Let's get back on the road. And, yes! Right, cool. Favorite franchise, Grand Theft Auto. Boom, done. Next question is from Blake Pollock. And he asks, what is my favorite game and why? Oh, am I getting the cops on me? Oops. My favorite game and why? I think it would have to be... Ah, it's such a hard question. I think the game that I enjoyed the most and I went back to the most is Fallout 3. It could have gone on my favorite franchise, but to be fair, I haven't played 1 or 2. New Vegas was alright. I didn't enjoy it as much as 3. But I think Fallout 3 is probably my favorite game of all time. Which, it's, I don't know, I can't... It makes me really excited for... Oh, excuse me. It makes me really excited for Fallout 4 because I played Fallout 3 to absolute death. I loved that game so much. It was so much depth in it. And I just loved all the little things around the world that you can find. Playing The Witcher at the minute. One of the things I keep coming back to is like... I feel far more invested in this world. And it sounds really strange. But if I had a home... If I had somewhere I could go at the end of each like game session and just drop off a load of gear so I could pretty much not have to worry about weight so much. Like, I could keep pretty much any of the special items that I ever got. And I could decorate it. And that was one of the things I loved so much about Fallout 3 is being able to get a house. And I just got a text. Being able to get a house and... it's off. My phone is off. And... decorated to how you wanted it. It was really cool. I really enjoyed that. Especially my Megaton house was always my favourite. Ah, it's just such a cool game. So many enemy variants. Is that the right word? And I probably played that game through 3 or 4 times. Just in different ways. And I enjoyed it the same every single time. Even if I did do the same things on a couple of the times. Like, even just small decision. Well, it's not a small decision, is it? Like, blowing up Megaton. And that can just change how you play the game so much. It was great fun. I think I did a run where I just went around and killed every single person I met. It kind of causes some problems for like the game overall, but it doesn't really matter. It's just a kind of game where you can do that kind of thing. It's just one of the games that I had the most rapport with. And I think I probably put more hours into that game than any other. Okay, so I think the next question is along the same lines as those, actually. Let's, hey, where are we? Let's have a little check on the map. We are at... okay, that's a field. I didn't really want that. Is that Santa Fe? I think that's Santa Fe. Are we going to come up on anything interesting? I hope we are. I hope we haven't missed anything interesting. Interesting. MacLeod's over here, so we are gonna go across Hoover Dam, which is good, that's fun. I don't know where the Grand Canyon is, I swear I've been there. Maybe it's that, is that the Grand Canyon? We might get to pass over the Grand Canyon if that's the Grand Canyon, it might be. Maybe. Okay, so while we're loading up, I will get the next question, which is... it's another question from Hellbringer457, which is, what is your favourite open world game? Kind of app that we're talking about that while we're playing this game. My favorite open world game, it's another one that's kind of hard for me because I play so many, and I think it really comes down to what is the open world that feels the most alive, I guess. It's a hard question actually, because on one hand, I want to say Grand Theft Auto 5, purely because that is a beautiful open world, and it actually feels like a living, breathing city, which is it's really cool, and that's something that a lot of games just can't capture. Then I could say something like Just Cause 2, because that world is massive and it's just a playground of destruction pretty much, and it's so much fun. Or then I could go down the whole Fallout route again, where it's just a really detailed world where you can run into absolutely anything around the corner and you never know what you're going to run into, and so many interesting locations. I don't know, I don't think I can actually answer this question. That's a really difficult question to answer. I don't think I can say one specifically, because there are so many different aspects that make an open world good. Like, I could probably even say, I don't know if many people would have played this game, but the original Mercenaries, I think it was called Playground of Destruction. That was literally what it was, just a playground of destruction, and it was an open world game where you had pretty much anything you wanted. You could call in a tactical nuke and just bomb a city. And that is so much fun, and all the buildings were destructible. And that's another aspect of open world that I just love, just the freedom. So I don't think I can actually answer that question. There's too many different things to take into account. Even Red Dead could come into that, because that was such a different world which felt alive, just like GTA 5 does. That is really annoying that I can't look behind. I'm going to go into this view for a bit. So I don't think I can actually answer that question. There are too many open world games that I think... Oh, this is the Grand Canyon. Cool. Let's just go and have a quick look. There are too many open world games that I just think do different things in different ways too well. Right, sorry about that. I had to have a quick break. The question of open world game, I think it's such a hard question to answer for the pure fact there are so many variables that can come into account. And this is a really cool place. Like, even this, just the pure fact that the idea of this open world where they've just got the whole of America and squashed it down, I think that's a really cool idea for an open world game. But would I say it's my favourite ever? No, because it's not. And then, I don't know. It's just different aspects that fall into that question that I can't narrow down into one answer. So the question to what is my favourite open world game is, I don't know. I play too many and I find too many of them interesting, really, to choose one of them over the other. So that's a question, but I can't answer it. Okay, we are going to go straight into another question, because we're actually... I don't know, maybe we should drive for a bit before we go on to the next one, because we have only a few left. Right, I think... Oh, there's a little caravan. Hello, caravan. Right, I'm going to go back into the inside view. It's really upsetting me that flashes. I think I actually managed to get everyone's questions in. Maybe I want to talk a bit about actually getting 10,000 subscribers, because that is something that I don't think I ever expected I'd actually ever reach. Like, I always wanted to, say, reach something that high, but when I started, maybe because I'd had so many other channels, as I talked about earlier, I always expected that, yeah, this one won't work either. I'll never actually be able to, like, get a base of subscribers so large, and I'm so happy that I actually did, because it just shows that my hard work pays off in the end. And I can't remember how long I've been doing this for. I think I might have been doing it since 2012, and I know compared to other channels that's actually a really small growth, but I think the Royal Gorilla channel has been kind of going through different stages, kind of. Like, it started off very strong, just constant Easter egg videos, and then maybe I wanted to try some different stuff with some live action vlogs and different shows, and maybe I did it a bit too early. But I think the channel has now found its footing in a good place, I think. If you don't follow me on Twitter, which you really should, because why not? I have been talking recently about actually kind of creating a more scheduled content for every week. I wanted to start making a top 5 video every Wednesday and releasing that, which could be pretty much anything, maybe even some non-game related ones, because I do find just what a top 5 video is, I find it interesting, and I like making them because I learn new stuff, and I then get to tell people the new stuff that I've learned, if that makes sense to you. I can't even speak, if that makes sense to you. And then I was going to think Saturdays were for a Let's Play, which I definitely want to start making more of, because Let's Play content is something that I've always wanted to get into, but I didn't know whether the subscribers I have are wanting Let's Play content. Are they here for other types of content? But hopefully, if I give them the other type of content in the form of Easter egg videos, which will kind of come randomly, because someone actually asked me, am I still going to be doing Easter egg videos? Because I hadn't done one in quite a while. And the answer is yes, because I only do Easter egg videos when I have a new game with Easter eggs in it. And that can actually be kind of the limiting factor on that. So if the channel completely relied on Easter egg videos, I'd have masses of time with just no videos going out. Because one, I don't have money, to be honest. I have hardly any money. I'm a student. I'm living on a student loan, basically, and that leaves me absolutely nothing to live on. And especially buy games with, which is pretty much a luxury for me at this point. So having a new game to play and make Easter egg videos in, it can be tricky to actually get hold of it. Where are we at the minute? St. George. Okay. So that can be kind of hard. And the other thing, I don't remember what I was talking about now. Machinimas. I love making them. They're so much fun. They get decent views. I don't even mind if they don't get many views at all. I just enjoy making them. And they all come kind of randomly throughout the week, I guess. Like, Easter eggs and that, they're not going to have a specific day, purely because of the fact that Easter eggs in particular, I will get them out as soon as I make them. And machinimas, they take a long time to make. Maybe that will replace a Let's Play for a week, maybe, or something like that. But I don't want to fix myself down saying, oh, this time every month will be a machinima. Or every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, you'll get an Easter egg video. Because I just can't do that. One, I don't have the time. And two, I don't have the time. And I don't have the games. And some games actually just don't have Easter eggs. You'll be surprised at how many they don't. Quite a few games that I bought recently, they're just not up to the cut for Easter eggs. Some might have really small ones. I know for a fact that in The Witcher 3 there's an Easter egg which references Skyrim in the game Gwent, which is literally all it says is on one of the cards, which is an archer, it said we'll end your turn with an arrow to the knee or something like that, something along them lines, which is obviously a reference to Skyrim. But if I make a video with one line which is an Easter egg from a virtual card in a game which isn't even really about the card game, I say, oh, look at this amazing Skyrim Easter egg. I'm like, well, it's not really amazing. It's not worthy of a video, in my opinion. I prefer ones that are actually substantial, like the Tyrion Lannister Easter egg I just released in The Witcher, and, of course, the Holy Grail, which is actually a really cool Easter egg. I was glad they put that in. So, yeah, that's the answer to the Easter egg question. And we only have about 11 miles left. So I'm going to actually carry on with these questions, because I normally actually do them quite slow. Right, let's get on to the next question. It's kind of carrying on from the open world theme. Am I hyped? Am I hooped? Wolfie TW asks, am I hyped for Just Cause 3? The answer is yes, of course I bloody am. That game is... I don't even care. I'm going to pre-order that because I know it's going to be a good game. Oh, quite frankly, how could it not? Like, the only way they could make a Just Cause not good is if they made it gritty and unrealistic. Well, realistic, I guess. Oh, it's really weird. Like, if they released Just Cause 2 as Just Cause 3, providing that Just Cause 2 never existed, that's a strange thing to say. Anyway, I would be like, this is a great game. Even in like 2015, it would be so much fun, and I play it for the fun. I don't care about storyline or anything like that. It's just so much fun to play. And Just Cause 3 looks like it's gonna just hype everything up. The destructible environments look so much fun, and I can't wait to have a go just smashing shit up. So yes, I am definitely hyped for Just Cause 3. Okay, have we... how far are we? Have we even got to Hoover Dam yet? Oh, I just realised something. That's not our final destination. That is. So we have more time than I realised. Which is good. So I can actually go into these questions a little more in depth. That's like a half... No, not a halfway point. Like a three quarters point. That's cool. I've been doing this mile thing wrong all along. Well done, Luke. You're a flipping idiot. So I can actually go into more depth in these questions. Yeah, we'll stick on the Just Cause 3 question then for a bit. The video I posted, the top 5 most anticipated games for E3, I think I pretty much summed it up in that, where I said, essentially, Just Cause 3 is pretty much bombastic fun. There's no two ways about it. They've taken everything in an open world game that's fun and ramped it up by a billion. And maybe I can answer my question for my favourite open world game once that game comes out. And maybe I will let you know that. I actually did a top 5 open world games, didn't I? I can't remember who won that. I don't know if that was based on my opinion or not. Or it was a... I don't think it was. I think that was based on a user score system or something like that. I don't know. I can't remember. I think the answer was Grand Theft Auto 5 or something along them lines. But yes, I am most definitely hyped. Oh god, I can't breathe. I'm most definitely hyped for Just Cause 3. Okay, I'm going to... Wait, where are we? Are we nearly at the... This kind of looks familiar. I feel like I've been here before. Oh, I think I am. I'll wait until we're over the next place to do another question. Right, come around the corner. Whoa. Yeah, I definitely recognise this road. I've been to Hoover Dam 3 times, I think. I most recently went last year. If you've been on my vlogging channel, which is just Luke Big, all caps, you'll probably if you've seen it already, then you've obviously seen it. But if you haven't, there are videos over there. Where am I? Am I on the bridge? Hang on. Oh, there's the blooming dam. Right, we're going to have to go back across that way because that is where I want to be. Hang on. I can just see it like that, actually. Yeah, Hoover Dam. Probably one of my favourite landmarks in America. I don't know why it's my favourite, but I don't know. I just really like it. Been there about 3 times. If you want to see that, it's on my vlogging channel. One of my California 2013 videos, I believe. And that's the time I actually went with Lauren. So if you want to see me and Lauren on holiday, go watch that. There's also some actually more, I don't know. There's some vlogging content over there, but I don't really know what standard it is because I'm not really into the whole vlogging scene. I just make it when I'm bored and want to have some fun. I find them videos like that just fun to make. Kind of like this, actually. This is just nice, just rambling. And I kind of ramble onto some weird topics, but that's what I like about my vlogging channel. It's just... randomness most of the time. So I've got 3 miles left until this little three quarter point, so I might do one more question. Let's have a look. Okay, Dewey Perry, I don't know, I can't read these names, asks, okay, I'm gonna pull over for this one because it's complicated and I'm not sure I understand it. I'm going to do a dramatic reading of this one. Do you like pineapple cake mixed with a beautiful a strand of nose hair? Oh, and some lemon milk. One, you should check for typos. Two, what the fuck? Three, I don't really know, you could get pineapple cake. Is that an actual thing or has he made that up? I feel like I heard of carrot cake and like fruit cake. Can you have pineapple in a fruit cake? No, surely not, it's like raisins. I never heard of pineapple cake. Someone let me know if he's made that up or if I'm just not down with the cakes. Oh, that's a cool view, look at that. Yeah, so that was a strange question. What's the last part? Nose hair, no, that can go away. And lemon milk. I'm not a fan of milk. I have milk on cereal and that's pretty much it, so flavoured milk? No, thank you. No, thank you. So that was a weird question. I did say that I can have some weird oh, I should really look where I'm going. Why is that flashing? Really annoying. Oh. Right, EDM Galaxy is most wanted. Where are we now? We're actually in Vegas. We are, there is Mandalay Bay, I believe, which was the first place I stayed when I went to Vegas. I'm just gonna give you like kind of a tour of where I've been and crap. Right, yeah, that's Mandalay Bay, isn't it? I can't see this view yet. Mandalay Bay up there, which is, it was really nice actually. The airport's over there. What's that one? What's that? Oh, there's the Luxor, which is, I don't know, it's a cool one. I want to stay in there one day, but I don't know. I don't know what they are. I don't know if they're actually a named casino hotel. This kind of looks a little off. I don't know. That is, of course, I want to say it's Camelot, which is the version of it from Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, but no, it's Excalibur. That is Excalibur. What is over there? That's the MGM. Where's the MGM? I just saw it. Is that it? Did I go past it? This is the MGM Grand. Yeah, it must be. Is it? Yeah, that's the MGM Grand, which is the MWP Grand, apparently. Here we have New York, New York, which is the closest we've been to New York in this video. Caesar's Palace, of course. Paris. Well, I've gone past the Venetian yet. I don't know. Whoa, roadworks. I am on the wrong side of the road. I didn't actually realise that. Oh, that's the, I can't remember what that, the Mirage. That's the Mirage with its water fountain-y things. Wait, was that whole thing the Mirage? And this is Caesar's Palace. Yeah, this one's Caesar's Palace. I can't remember what that is. That one is the Venetian. There's the Venetian. Over here, we should have... But this is where I stayed last, and it's just not here. This should be Treasure Island. But Treasure Island is apparently not here, which is strange. Don't know why. And they are the Encore and the Win. Don't know which order. Ah, Circus Circus up here. Cool. This is I love just looking at stuff like this. This is why I like this game. It's the only reason I bought it is just so I could come to places like this and be like, ah, I've been there. I've been there. And I can't remember what the big tower's called. Huh. I don't know. There's a plane up there. I managed to drive on the wrong side of the road all the way down there and not crash. Okay, let's open up the map. We're in Vegas right now. We are now going to head up into our top right-hand corner. Right hand? Left hand? I don't know my hands. Right, let's set our waypoint. Beautiful. We're going to go up that way around that mountain. Cool. I don't know how far this is going to be. We'll see. That would depend how many questions we can answer because I've... 26 miles, so in total we've, when did we start on 70? So we're, I've gone the wrong way already, oh god, roughly 100 miles we've had to travel in this video, which is kind of cool. Must be like 100 mile across the map, I guess. It's a nice big map, and the pure fact that it takes so long to get across is cool. I just thought how long this video is going to take to upload. Jesus, that's going to be forever. Oh, it's the old Vegas. It's a really cool bit. I've never actually been in it. Oh god, dodge. Whoa, through the middle. Nice. I wonder if the porn stars are around here. That's porn with a P-A-W-N. not the other kind. I'm pretty sure they're all over Vegas. You don't need to go to a specific spot. Okay. I can't work out if that's... Ow, ow, ow. No, it was just cloud. I thought there was a dust storm going on. I don't think this game has weather, which is sad. I think it might have rain, and that's pretty much it. But I doubt I'd really see much rain out here in the desert, would I? Okay. We're on our way, so let's answer another question. We're on our last three questions. I'm going to make these last. I don't know what they're about. So we have Mastermind 21. That's a cool name. I like that. Cool name. Okay, I had this question and I didn't understand what he meant at all. So I'm going to try and work it out. He said, can you put your other intro thing at the end? Can I put my other intro thing at the end? I don't know what that means. Like, I understand that I have my intro, which is the Royal Gorilla text drop down with the music, and maybe he wants that at the end of the video, as well as the start, instead of having the end card with my song that LuiCAcoustic wrote for me. Maybe. Maybe he just wants a different ending rather than the one I have at the minute. I don't know. I don't understand what he meant by that. So, if you did mean that you wanted me to put the intro at the end, that's something I do that on certain videos. I will do that on Machinima videos because I feel that's more professional for that kind of thing. Whereas on a gaming related video, which is likely to get lots of views, I will put my end card because, oh, let's stop in this, because it's most likely to get more people to see my other content, which is good. Where are we? The Boneville Salt Flats. I thought it was rather flat here. I didn't realise there are animals in this game. They look really, really bad. Why would you do a close-up on them? Right, which way are we heading? This way. Can we just drive across the salt flats? Oh, look at that. This is... Oh, God, that's weird. It's really cool, though. I'm just going to drive in the salt flats for a bit. You know, as long as we're heading in the right direction. Should we switch our view? Wow, that is really cool. Like Death Valley. Apart from you can see the road. And it's going to end right here. It doesn't last very long, does it? Let's go back in. Yeah, so if you want me to put that intro at the end of more, then... No. I don't really know what you meant. I do have three ending cards that I rotate between. So maybe he was just seeing one more than the others. I don't know, I need to make some new ones of them. I just bought Killing Floor and Killing Floor 2, actually. I'm really excited to play them, actually. I don't know, I haven't played them yet. So, I'll probably make a new ending card with one of them in. Which will be cool. It'll be fun. So, yeah, there you go. 18 miles left. I think maybe it's time for another question? What is that vibration? I don't know. Right, next question. Comes from Majora's Child. I think that's how you say it. Majora's Child. Whoa, dodge. Keep dodging. He asks, what is your favourite character in a video game and why? My favourite character in a video game. Ah. Hard question. I'm going to have a think about this one. Because most of the game I play, that's great grammar, Luke. Most of the games I play, you normally play a faceless individual. Well, no, you don't, do you? What's my favourite character? That's actually kind of hard. That is a really hard question. There's not too many, like, characters that are like, whoa, that character, that's awesome character. Not really sticking out to me all that much. You're going to have some moments of silence here while I try and think, because I'm actually really racking my brain to work this one out. My favourite character... I don't know if it's cheating, or can I say my favourite character is a character that I create? I don't know if that's cheating to say that. Because I love it when you can make your own character. Like, Fallout 3, Grand Theft Auto Online even. I love my Grand Theft Auto Online character. I made a Machinima series about her, for God's sake. It's just so much. I like to be able to have the freedom to shape the world and the character. And it's kind of strange that I play as a female so much, but it's not really strange. I don't know why I play as a female character so much. I do in GTA Online. I did in most of my Fallout games, I think. If I have the option, I will genuinely play as a female. No idea why I do that. Strange. Well, dodge them. So, my favorite... Oh, you see that truck, like, bopping through the floor then? Favorite female? I can't even speak now. My favorite game character... I'm going to try and answer it with someone that's not one that I create myself. I'm trying to think back to other games. Some people like Mario and that, but I've never been a Nintendo fan, really. I had Game Boys and stuff and a Nintendo 64, but it didn't really extend any further than that. My favourite game character... That is such a hard question. I hate that question. I hate you for asking that question. I'm going to ban you from the channel for that question. No, don't worry, I won't. Give me a second. Let's just pull over. Pull over. That was an awful way to pull over. I nearly went back in the road like 3 times. Okay, right. I'm going to go over and have a look in my cupboard at my enormous collection of games, which is like 5, and see which game I think has the best character and use that as my answer. So, bear with me. I won't be long. Just stay on there. Just call The Witcher. Titanfall, Watch Dogs, Spider-Man, Dying Light. Maybe. Maybe not. I don't know. I have no idea. I'm inclined to say maybe... I don't know. That is a horrible question. And I hate you for asking me because I have no idea as to the answer of that. That is a mean question. I don't know who my favourite game character is, and it's a sad fact that I have just realised I do not have a favourite game character. Thank you for making me sad. Actually, hang on. Let's pull over again. One more chance to redeem ourselves. Let's have a look in my games and apps. See if there is a game in here which I'm like, oh yeah, that character is really good. No. Absolutely none. I don't know. If it was anyone, it'd probably be from one of the from a Xbox 360 game. Probably one I played a long time ago, so I'm not going to remember it, which is annoying. But then again, it doesn't have to be a character that you play as, does it? It kind of makes it. Okay, I'm going to go for Triss from The Witcher 3. Because she's hot and I have a thing for redheads. Boom, done. There you go, that was my question and I answered it really easily because I went for the hottest girl I could think of. What an easy answer. Oh god, we are nearly there. Let's rack off these last... Oh, we've only got one question left anyway. Doesn't matter, we'll just use this last question up to get home. Home? You know what I mean. Banter Squirrel asks, how long do you plan to keep doing YouTube? P.S. I love your videos. Big smiley face. How long do I plan to keep doing YouTube? As long as it's feasible, really. I'd love to say I could do it for the rest of my life. And like one day have this as my profession, if you want. If you want to see it that way. But in all honesty, will YouTube last for that long? I don't know. Anything could happen. A number of things can happen. It could just stop being feasible as a way to make money because maybe ads stop seeing it as something profitable. Could be absolutely anything. Game developers could say that they don't want their videos featured anymore. There's just too many variables. Oh God, why does it want me to go through the woods? So the answer is, I want to do this as long as I can. And that's really the simplest answer I can give you. For as long as I'm able to make videos, I will make videos. Because I enjoy doing it, for one. And the idea of this being something I can do permanently at one stage in my life, at some stage in my life rather, makes me... That's like insane. That's just so perfect. Like, imagine being able to get the perfect job, and that's what this would be for me. And if this was able to support me full time, then that'd be great. So I don't think the question gets any simpler answer than that. As long as I can, I will make videos for as long as I can. And with that, we are nearly there. We're just coming through this woods, and we should come out onto the ocean soon, which will be interesting. I don't actually... Oh, I heard seagulls. Yeah, you see, right on cue. So, I'm just going to have quite a long wrap-up of this video, I think. We pushed an hour long. If you actually managed to stick around for that long, it's either because... we crashed. Crashed right near the end. Great. If you managed to stay with us this long, I'm sorry if I got a bit rambly. I'm sorry if I maybe, I don't know. I don't know what I might have done during this video. I can't really remember. It was nice to record, just to kind of sit back and play a game for so long and just talk. So I want to say just one more massive thank you to every single person that has subscribed to me, all 10,000 of you. That's it's really incredible that so many people like what I do. Oh God, I can't put it into words how happy I am that I've managed to come this far, and I've got so many people that were willing to pretty much... I find this hard to word because I don't want to say it in the wrong way. That's racist. Luke, you're a racist. I'm so sorry. I don't want to say it in the wrong way. And it's so good to feel... It's so hard to put into words, you know. It's so good to feel... I feel like I want to say gratified, but I don't know if that's actually the right word. It's good to have the feeling that what I'm doing here, what I'm creating, people are enjoying, and they're enjoying the content that I make. And it's good to see that in the response to the videos, to how many people subscribe to me, that they actually like the content I'm making. And we've actually had a massive influx lately of the amount of people that have been subscribing. When I reached 10,000, I was like, oh yes, we made it. A bit earlier than I expected, actually. And then I looked at it like the next day and I was like, 10,150. Like, where did you lot come from? There must be a video I posted recently that is just getting loads of views. It might be the Dying Light All Easter Eggs video. They always do pretty well. So, yeah, let's get back on track. Thank you, absolutely every one of you that subscribed. It means so much to me, and I just want to thank every last one of you. I wish I could do it personally, but we would be here forever. Maybe for my 20,000 subscriber video, I will just spend, like, all day. Sorry, I burped. Oh, jeez. I'll spend all day just saying thank you to every single one. That would be a really interesting video. I may do that one day. It wouldn't. It would be really, really boring. But it'd be kind of strange. So, yes, there we have it, guys. That was my 10,000 subscriber milestone video. And we made it across America. I don't know where we've ended up now. I've just been driving for a little bit. Oh, have we gone back on ourselves? No, really. We're just heading down this way. So there we are. We are over here now. Where do we come from? All the way down here. Took us just about an hour, I reckon. Wow, that is a long trip, and we've been here a long time getting to this point. Those of you that have been subscribed to me from the start, thank you so much. You've been with me like 3 years now. That's mental. And to the rest of you, thank you so much for subscribing. You don't know how much it means to me. If you made it to the end of this video, congratulations. Actually, I want to see how many people made it to the end of this video. I'm going to give you a password. The password will be... I know. No, I don't know. What's the password going to be? God, my mind is not working. An hour of driving does not work for my mind. Right, the password is going to be tuna sandwich. So, if you made it all the way to this point in the video, in the comment section below, put tuna sandwich. Just so I see how many people actually made it. I could probably just watch the retention on the analytics. I can't say that word. Analytics? I don't know. But, yeah, I think that's a more fun way to do it. So, if you made it, congratulations. Tuna sandwich in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Oh, God, that was a long one. I hope you enjoyed it, though. And we'll be sure to carry on subscribing. Make sure you like this video. Comment if you got to this point, tuna sandwich. And we'll join me next time for more content. I am going to go to sleep now and then edit this video, which will take forever. Whew. I've been the Royal Gorilla. Thank you. And over and out.
His name is Luke and he's more than your average gamer. No ordinary let's player. No but Easter eggs much better. Da 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 da. His name is Luke, aka the Royal Gorilla. Even bigger than the giant Godzilla. Follow him in every game he goes. Da 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 da. He's almost got everything you need, from GTA 5 to Assassin's Creed. And now that you have heard